brand new feature inside of Photoshop 2022 is Object Finder under the Object Selection. So, you know, when you see the movies and they say enhance and then they just kind of select something by just clicking on it, it's here. Let me show you. So if we go to the Object Selection tool, you're going to see under Object Finder is turned on and this little wheel is turning. That means it's looking for all the objects inside the photo. Now, get ready to have your mind blown. As I roll over, it appears in blue. But the Object Selection tool, you make a selection around one object and you select it, but this enables it to find every single object inside the image. And to select it, just simply click. All right, let's look at some of the other features that are in here and some of the other options. And by the way, this is part of my new feature series, so check them all out on YouTube and Photoshop Cafe. And by the way, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. All right, so the other option is if we go up the top and I want to see all the objects in the photo, just click this button and it shows you all the objects. Now, there's different options on how we can show these objects. If we hit the little gear, it has an object subtract. What that does is it enables us to find the object within the object, like you can see there on that overlay, you know, when things are cut out. We can do auto or manual refresh. Well, auto refresh means that if I'm working on a photo or I'm compositing, maybe I'm cloning and things like that, as soon as it sees a new object, it's going to keep looking for those. So manual refresh is going to say, you know what, why don't we just freeze this right where it is right now? Obviously, those are still selected. But then that means I can work on the image, and then when I'm ready to manually have it look again, I can click on that button. Let's keep it in auto for now. Other options is we can change the color. So say, for example, we want to make it green or other colors. And if we want to put an outline around there, this is kind of interesting. Let's put an outline. So we roll over there. You can see that outline. That was a pretty big one, but you get the general idea. Let's make the outline a little smaller maybe. There we go. So that's another way of working. And then, of course, we've got the always show, never show. So I like the never show will be like this. So you can see, we know there's objects in here, but it's not going to show them. So if I want to select them, just simply click, and it'll still select the object. The other thing is, even though we're in this option here where it says never show, we can go to always show, which just means literally everything's going to show all the time. I prefer the auto so I can roll over them. Now there's another option in here which is really useful. If we go up under layer, and then under layer, we choose to mask all objects. What this is going to do is it's going to look for all the objects. So it creates all these layer groups. And then we can simply select one. So maybe I want to make an adjustment just on here. I could grab a curves adjustment. It'll apply it right in there to that group. And notice now I'm just adjusting that one object. So if you haven't yet, check out my other tutorial where I walk through all the new features inside of Photoshop quickly, and then I've got more in-depth ones on every feature, so check those out. And by the way, guys, let me know in the comments underneath what you think of this feature, if this is something you think you would use. If you're new to Photoshop Cafe, welcome. Consider hitting that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. Do me a favor, guys, if you like this, smash that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.